That's it. What's going on there?
In the technological human development, a person gets to suffering nevertheless.
Again?
Since the technological evolution, as we develop, technologically, we nevertheless reach suffering. There's no...
True. What else is the development for?
Exactly, so... How can you bring people to...
Our whole development is in order to come to more and more subtle and meaningful suffering. Suffering that is closer and closer to the spiritual suffering.
The technological development?
Yeah, sure. Sure, what is this technology about? What is on the one hand, it makes our life easier. On the other hand, it shows us the nothingness of our life.
Right.
So the person becomes, the human becomes more and more sensitive, receptive in seeing that life has no meaning, no essence. Even if I fill up this life with so many gadgets, what will I get out of that?
How can we advance it, not necessarily through sufferings, but to pass it to them that we need to work on a different plane?
The human works on this level, in this world, in his ego, and he wants to take advantage of his ego as much as possible, to live 1,000 years, to fill yourself up with many gadgets, to play from dawn to dusk, to do whatever the ego wants, and even if it doesn't want something, how will I make it want something so that I'll have something to give to it? Because most of the thing that we are creating, we don't need. You know, naturally, we only need some simple things. Go into the supermarket and look at how many redundant things there are there. There used to be, you know, like a grocery store. I remember you would go to like a, you know, you'd see on the shelf a few dairy things, a few, you know, flour, bread, things like that. And, you know, today, 1,000 kinds of everything. Why? We are trying to create new lacks, deficiencies for ourselves that we can later fill up and feel pleasure. Because without a sense of pleasure, there is no sense of life. If you give a human being today the same form of life as people lived 100 years ago, there was no concept of vacations, to go overseas for a week or two or something, or there's no such thing. Even a vacation day, only the Jews had the mandatory Sabbath because the Torah obligates it, but basically it didn't exist. What did people used to have? They had one room where all the family was there, and even the grandmother and grandfather. What are we talking about? Now try to put yourself in those shoes. That would be so much suffering. We constantly expand in our will to receive in order to finally understand that with everything we do, we are flawed. We can't fulfill it. And humanity goes deeper and deeper into despair. And the despair is simply because fulfilling the will to receive is simply impossible.
That's what I'm saying, exactly, that humanity is advancing in huge steps towards suffering, because how can you hasten it? How can we hasten this matter?
To speed it up, bring light to the world. If you unite and you'll have a quality of bestowal among you, which will truly become a bit clearer between you, you will see how you can influence the world. Like Baal HaSulam writes in the introduction to the Book of Zohar, how through this group, the light should flow on to everyone else. They don't need to work on that at all, but they'll feel what you feel. Just like now, how beginners come and within a matter of months, they're with us as if they studied 10 years like you. At once.
At once.
Yeah, yeah, right, at once. They'll receive it all at once, all the nations of the world. If we were already on a stable, good spiritual level, you would see a totally different world. A different world. The policies of your neighboring countries, everything.
So what do you recommend, to go inward?
I recommend that you will become human beings.